Frustration and confusion. That's how some people in our region say they feel about the new congressional map. This map was drawn by the state Supreme Court last month. The court ruled that the old districts were gerrymandered and gave an unfair advantage to Republican candidates. Our lead I-Team reporter, Andy Mahalchuk, is in your local election headquarters with the details. Andy?
Well, Candace, there has been a lot of Monday morning quarterbacking and critiquing of these new congressional maps, and that is sure to continue. But some people I spoke with in southern Luzerne County insist the new boundaries only serve to divide their communities. This neighborhood in Luzerne County, it may look like any other across our region, but the people who live here say it's been torn apart by the new congressional district maps. This is where the new 8th and 9th districts converge, at the border of Hazel Township and the borough of West Hazleton. So it's a very close call between the 8th and 9th districts. Consider this. These homes which face Green Street here in Hazel Township are in the 8th district. If you cross the alley here, going toward North Street, these homes are in the 9th district.
I just don't think it's fair to divide a district.
Attorney Frank Skakowski, the former mayor of West Hazleton, believes this neighborhood should be in the same district.
I was in West Hazleton. My business is West Hazleton, my law practice, my neighbor, all my friends. I gravitate toward the Hazleton area, and they put me in a district which at this point in time I'm not really familiar with, but I guess I'm going to have to.
His new district stretches to the south into the Harrisburg area and west to Danville, away from the district he has known for decades.
Two people from the same area going to the same voting that both will have to be voting for two different candidates. It just didn't make sense to me.
Jack Mundy was a Hazleton City Councilman for two decades and is a student of politics. He says maybe the human factor should be taken out of this process.
It probably should be done by a computer, impartial, fairly, so that there's equal number, so that any candidate would have a chance.
Eyewitness News political analyst David Yonkai thinks that as the dust settles, the new map will be understood and accepted by everyone, especially those running for office.
A lot of these candidates started their candidacies before the redistricting started, so people are aware of it, and I think they'll settle in. How are they uncomfortable about it? Some of them might be, but I think it'll work out.
And political observers say this controversy could happen all over again after the 2020 census, when state lawmakers once again redraw congressional maps on that data. Reporting from your local election headquarters, Andy Mahalchuk, Eyewitness News.
Andy, thank you. And on Monday, Governor Wolf announced two bills regarding gerrymandering. The first, House Bill 722, would create a 5-person independent redistricting commission, and that includes majority and minority leaders of the House and Senate. That group would draw the boundary lines for the district map. Another proposal, Senate Bill 22, would create a redistricting commission of 11 independent citizens.